want to turn it vertically, there's another shutter release button right here. So whichever way you prefer.
Thank you. STS-133 Mission Specialist Nicole Stott. Nicole, barely a month back from orbit yourself. Ron Garan, your colleague, your close friend,
ready to fly to the International Space Station that you just came back from and lived on not long ago. Your thoughts as you stand in this place in history today?
You know, I don't know. To me, it's pretty impressive overall. You know, the thing that stands out the most for me, I think, is that it is Ron's launch and getting to be here as his friend, you know, to support him and his family. But, you know, you look at this rocket that says Gagarin on the side and 50th anniversary, it all, you know, it all starts to come together. You know, even though I was just in space, the thought of all the history that's gone into bringing us here today and the fact that we as international partners are very, very happily standing here together to get ready for this launch, it's very impressive.
And not the least of which, 30th anniversary of space shuttle. So the juxtaposition of shuttle and Soyuz, your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I think, you know, that's interesting as well that, you know, as countries, how we've kind of evolved to this point. And I just got back on, like you mentioned, on 133, on the last flight of the space shuttle Discovery, which, you know, people are using this word bittersweet, and I can't quite go there. To me, it's a little bit more like bitter sad. But, you know, we stand here ready for a Soyuz launch where we as partners are continuing to fly together to go to the space station. And, you know, in hopes that that will continue for some time while we get ready again as the United States to come up with a new vehicle to transport us to station and beyond.
Ron's been training
for quite a while for this moment. He's looking forward to it. How do you think he's going to do for his 6 months in orbit?
I think he's going to do great. We spent 18 days, actually, on the NEMO mission, on one of the underwater missions together. And I can tell you, he's going to have a great time on station. It's such a beautiful place to appreciate not only space from, but our own planet from. And I think he's going to take a lot of that in and come back a happier guy.
Mike Lopez-Alegria, who's the Deputy Director for Flight Crew Operations for Space Station. Mike, behind you, the Soyuz rocket emblazoned with Gagarin's name and likeness on the side for the 50th anniversary, just 1 week shy of a half century of human spaceflight. Your thoughts on this moment in history and on the eve of this launch of another crew to the space station?
Well, Rob, it always has two parallel meanings here. I mean, on the one hand, we're here like we always are every 2 to 4 months watching a rollout that, you know, Roscosmos does with such precision and consistency. And on the other hand, as you say, 50 years, I mean, it's a huge milestone. It's hard to grasp what that means while you're standing here. But in the future, we're all going to look back on this moment and think it was pretty special, I'm sure.
You know, the 50th anniversary of Gagarin's launch is also the 30th anniversary of the first shuttle flight. It just is always interesting how the two programs fold into one another in this moment in history.
Yeah, it is very interesting. And as you know, we've got an interesting moment coming up here between the Progress and the Soyuz and the shuttle and whether or not we can deconflict those things. So as we have more and more traffic to the station, it gets more and more confused, more and more difficult to separate, and I think we'll be intertwined, you know, at least through this summer.
Ron Garan, you've talked to him. How's his level of preparation for what will be a complex half year in space?
Ronnie is a solid guy. He's ready. He's been looking forward to this for a long time. He's very professional. He knows what he's doing. We have full confidence in Ronnie.
And how complex will this half year for him and his incremental crew as they work their way through all of these visiting vehicles and the retirement of the space shuttle?
Lots going on. I mean, starting, as you said, with the anniversary events, which will be, you know, a certain type of distraction for him on orbit. On the other hand, the real critical issue during his period is going to be crew time. You know, we just don't have enough time between all the visiting vehicles, all the maintenance required for the ecosystems, and then, you know, the leftover time, so to speak, for utilization, which we really want to increase the focus on because we're transitioning from the assembly phase to the utilization phase. So he's going to have his hands full along with the rest of his crew.